knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
We've been discussing many general details regarding Subphylum Chelicerata, but we have yet to get a firm sense of the true diversity of this clade, so let's get a broader sense of the wide variety of species we have been discussing. There are nearly 100,000 described species of chelicerates, so it's impossible to go over every species in detail, particularly as new species are being described almost daily. In this tutorial, we will discuss all of the chelicerate orders, starting first with the major division between the three extant classes, Pycnogonida, Meristomata, and Arachnida. Class Pycnogonida contains about 1,300 species of sea spiders, all of which are within the order Pantopoda. They are found in marine habitats around the world, from shallow coastal waters to deep ocean basins, and are most abundant in polar waters. Most are only a few millimeters long, while others can grow up to 70 centimeters, or 2.3 feet. They have small bodies and long legs, of which there are usually 8, but maybe up to 12 in some species. Some recent studies have even argued that the sea spiders are actually of their own evolutionary lineage and should not be placed within Chelicerata. The paraphyletic class Meristomata contains just 4 extant species of horseshoe crabs, all of which are in order Ziphasura. They are not actually crabs and are more closely related to arachnids than crustaceans. They are easily recognized by their unsegmented, horseshoe-shaped carapace, which covers their prosoma and acts as a hard dorsal shell, as well as a broad opisthosoma and a long tailpiece, or telson, which they use to right themselves in the water and cannot sting or harm humans. They have 2 compound eyes on the sides of their prosoma, a pair of chelicerae, pedipalps, 4 pairs of walking legs, and a final pair of legs mainly used to clean and maintain their gills. Class Arachnida, commonly referred to as arachnids, is by far the most biodiverse and numerous class of Chelicerata. Nearly all adult arachnids have 8 legs attached to the cephalothorax, or prosoma. The name arachnid comes from the Greek arachne, meaning spider, from the myth of the human weaver Arachne, who was turned into a spider. However, arachnids are not just spiders, and the class is generally accepted to have 11 orders: Araneae, Acari, Amblypogae, Apiliones, Palpigradae, Pseudoscorpionida, Ricinulae, Schizomida, Scorpiones, Solifugae, and Thelifonida. Some of these clades will be more familiar than others. Let's start with perhaps the most familiar, Araneae, the spiders. There are over 50,300 described spider species, split into over 130 families. They have a wide range of sizes, from the extremely diminutive Patudigna, that is about 1/5 the head of a pin, to the Goliath bird eater, which can reach a leg span of nearly a foot wide. Many, like the orb weavers, can create intricate webs, while others, like the wolf spiders, actively forage for food. Some create communal webs, but most are solitary. They are nearly all carnivores, except for a few primarily vegetarian species, like Bagheera kiplingi. They are found worldwide on every continent except for Antarctica, and have become established in nearly every land habitat. They are distinguished by their chelicerae with hollow fangs, which are generally able to inject venom, and spinnerets that extrude silk. Order Acari contains at least 40,000 species split between 2 subgroups, Parasitiformes, which includes the ticks and a variety of mites, and Acariformes, which contains only mites split between 351 families and likely hundreds of thousands of undescribed species. They are incredibly numerous. In fact, there are probably about 1.5 to 2.5 million demodex, or face mites, living on your face right now. But don't worry, they don't hurt you, they're actually helpful. Most species are microscopic, less than 1 millimeter in length, and incredibly small, but some, especially ticks, are macroscopically visible as adults. They are distinguished from other arachnids due to their unique mouthparts, like their hypostome, which is derived from fused pedipalps. different species also have a wide range of morphologies. Order Amblypogae contains about 155 species of whip spiders. They are regionally common in tropical and subtropical regions worldwide. They are nocturnal hunters that only use 6 of their 8 legs for walking. The front pair of legs are modified for use as antennae-like feelers, with many fine segments giving the appearance of a whip. When suitable prey is located with the antenniform legs, the amblypogid seizes its victims with large spines on the grasping pedipalps, impaling and immobilizing the prey. Opiliones is the order of the harvest men, sometimes called daddy longlegs in the United States. We should note, though, that the common name daddy longlegs actually refers to a species of crane fly in the UK and a true spider in Australia, so it is best to call them harvest men. Harvest men are among the only chelicerates capable of ingesting non-liquid food. Contrary to some popular myths, all members of Opiliones are actually harmless to humans, as they have no venom glands. They include about 6,500 described species. They are not at all spiders and cannot produce silk. They are distinguished by their rounded and broadly jointed body segments and long walking legs. They are known to bob up and down to confuse predators and will sometimes congregate in huge numbers. Order Palpigradi includes about 60 species of microwhip scorpions, all of which are 3 millimeters in length or smaller and make their homes within the tropical and subtropical soils. Order Pseudoscorpionida contains about 3,200 species of pseudoscorpions, or false scorpions, also called book scorpions because they can sometimes be found within the pages of old books, hunting mites and book lice. Most are 3 millimeters or less in length and live within the top layer of the soil and leaf litter on the forest floor. Order Ricinulae includes just 91 described species of hooded tick spiders, most of which are less than half an inch or 5 to 10 millimeters long. They are noted for their hood, or cuculus, that can be raised and lowered over the head. Living Ricinulaeids have no eyes and inhabit the leaf litter of rainforest floors and caves. Order Schizomyda includes about 300 species of short-tailed whip scorpions. Like the whip spiders, they use 6 pairs of legs for walking, while their first 2 legs act as sensory organs. Order Scorpiones includes over 2,500 described species of organisms commonly called scorpions. Most hunt invertebrates, but some of the larger species specifically target vertebrates. Though 99% of them do not possess venom powerful enough to kill humans, about 25 species are venomous enough to cause death. Globally, about 1 million people are stung annually, and about 3,000 people die, primarily in more remote tropical areas with limited access to healthcare. Scorpions are easily distinguished from other arachnids due to their large and powerful scissor pedipalps and their elongated opisthosoma that has been modified into a pre- and post-abdomen and ends in a stinging apparatus. On their ventral side, they possess comb-like tactile pectines used for exploring the substrate and sex recognition. They mature remarkably slowly for arthropods, reaching sexual maturity in 1 to 8 years, and living up to 15 years or more in the wild. The 1,000 or so species of Solifugi are variously called sulpigids, wind scorpions, sun spiders, or camel spiders, but they are neither spiders nor scorpions. Unlike spiders and scorpions, they are, like the harvestmen, entirely non-venomous, even though some species possess extremely large chelicerae, which they use to grind their prey. Most are small, but the largest can reach lengths of 12 to 15 centimeters, or 5 to 6 inches in length. Though they are the subject of a number of myths and urban legends, they pose almost no threat to humans, have no venom delivery apparatus, and though they can run quickly in short bursts, they do not chase humans. Finally, order Tholiphanida, or Uropogy, are the whip scorpions, or vinegaroons, so named for their ability to discharge an offensive vinegar-smelling liquid, which contains acetic acid. There are about 100 species of whip scorpions distributed mainly in humid tropical areas, except for the giant scorpion, which is common in the American Southwest. Though they are powerful nocturnal hunters, they have no venom glands, and like most arachnids, pose no threat to humans. And with that, we wrap up Chelicerata. It's important to remember that a more modern view posits that there are actually only two extant arthropod subphyla, Chelicerata and Mandibulata. This means that the chelicerates, all the animals we've just described, are actually the sister taxon to all other arthropods, which are in Mandibulata. Keeping that in mind, we've still got a lot of arthropods to study. Let's move forward and begin looking at Myriapoda, which is the sister group to Pancrustacea.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.